Hey, what's up everyone? This is Dave from the Adobe Character Animator team. And in this video, I'm going to give you a quick update of all the cool things we've been adding into Character Animator Beta. That includes a mix of old and new stuff. So new stuff like transcript-based lip sync and smart replays, two features we haven't showed you anything about before. And then some existing features that we have previewed in the past, but we've made a lot of improvements to based off of your feedback. And that includes body tracking and the puppet maker tool. So these are not in the shipping version right now. So you need Character Animator Beta to use them. So if you have no idea what that means, check out the video description below for more information on how to get access to that. And the whole reason I'm doing this video is to get more feedback from you all. So we think these are in a really good state and they're continuing to improve every day. But the way they're improving is based off of your feedback. You're sending us your puppet files, videos of things that are going wrong, ideas you have for ways we could make these features better. So please check this out and let us know what you think in the comments or the forums, and I'll talk more about that at the end. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. By now, you know how Character Animator's automatic lip sync works. You start talking, your character starts talking, we analyze the audio of what you're saying and give you the right mouth shape to show up at any given time. And most of the time that works really well. But sometimes maybe you're making a cartoon show and you've got a script of all the things that your character is saying, or you have a transcript of some sort of a explainer video you're doing, and you wish that you could use that script to make the lip sync just a little bit more accurate. So it knows exactly where certain sounds are, where, you know, words begin and end, and just make that lip sync as accurate as possible and require less cleanup later on if you do want to dig in there and try to fix a few things. Well, luckily, in the beta now, there is transcript-based lip sync. So if you import an audio file and select it here in the project panel, check out what happens over here under the properties. You now see a section for transcript. And so if I were to type in here the transcript or copy and paste either just from a text file or an SRT captions file or something like that, then you can use that to create a more accurate lip sync for your character. Here's a side-by-side video I put together where I first did just compute lip sync from scene audio, the old way of doing things, and then another one where I did the transcript added in. See if you can spot the difference between the two. Now, this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. So the differences are pretty subtle, but if you do have an eye for this sort of thing, you should see that the one on the right feels a little bit more accurate and connected to the actual words that are being said. So I'll give you an example. In one part I say, my life got flipped, turned upside down. The transcript base understands that this flipped part is showing up, whereas the original is missing out on that. And there's a little bit more of some chatter in the original where, shapes are kind of holding on, or there's some background noise or something like that that's making a certain S or D sound for this character. That's not showing up at all here in the transcript-based version. The main thing I've noticed is that transcript-based lip sync seems to hit the individual vowel and consonant sounds a lot better. So I do tend to see more things like this, where a particular, you know, woo sound or O sound or an in-between or that F I was talking about before do show up a lot more as opposed to the original. Again, it's a pretty subtle thing and maybe you think it's not that big a deal, but lip sync is such a critical part of making a character seem believable. And when it's off even just a little bit, it can really take someone out of the experience. So, you know, for the best possible results, we think transcript-based lip sync is going to work really, really well. Now, this is great timing because Premiere Pro just recently added auto transcription and captions. This is a fantastic feature which will take any of your videos and automatically analyze what you're saying and add the transcript and captions if you want them. So what I can do is I've got this sequence here and I'm gonna go select it, I'm in my captions workspace over here, go to transcribe sequence, go ahead and click transcribe. That's going to go through a processing step of finding that audio and figuring out the exact words that I'm saying. And there you go, there's the results. And they actually look really great. If I needed to edit anything, I could go in here, double click them and change it. But everything looks really accurate, including some of the punctuation from what I'm seeing. So this is looking really good. Now I could just copy and paste this and bring it into Character Animator in that little text field window that I showed you. But I'm going to add one more step to it. I'm going to actually create captions and get some more precise timing of what's being said. So I'm going to go here and click Create Captions. That's going to bring up this little dialogue. I'm going to hit Create. It's going to go ahead and do the Create Captions processing step. And now I have a captions track that's showing up for each of these. So what I can do from here is go ahead to the little more menu icon over here, click it and say export to SRT file. That is a very standard captions track file that you can use. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Save it as whatever I want. Let's just call this Bel Air. And that's all there is to it. You know, you don't have to have a video either. You could just bring your audio track here into Premiere and just do the transcription directly from that. For this, I've got the video. So if I did want that audio track, I could actually just export it out very easily. So I could go to, you know, File, Export, Media. And by default, mine's usually set to H.264. I'm going to change that to an AIFF file, an audio file, and go ahead and export that out. And now I've got my audio file from my video as well. All right, so now back in Character Animator, I do have my audio file up here that I've imported. And what I wanna do is select that. And over here in the transcript section, I'm gonna go ahead and click the import button. And then I'm gonna find that SRT file, which is right here. Let's go ahead and import that. And you can see that it shows up with all the timing information over here in this panel. So now this transcript is attached to this audio file. So anything I do with it, this transcript is going to follow it. So let's go ahead and take this audio file and drag it into my scene. And now what I'm gonna do is select both my character that I want the lip sync to be applied to, as well holding down shift, select the audio file that I want to do the transcript-based lip sync on. And then I'm going to go to timeline, and instead of going to the usual compute lip sync take from scene audio, you'll notice there's this new one down here, compute lip sync take from audio and transcript. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. And there you go. Now I've got that accurate lip sync based off of the transcript. So I know my words, my everything is lining up as good as I can possibly expect. Broadcast TV shows that are using Character Animator, this is how they've started to do it. And it really works well and saves the animators a lot of time and from cleaning up and edits later on. So we would love for you to try this out. Note that in the beta currently, this is English only, so you are limited by that for now. But in the future, we hope to expand this out and make it work better for many more languages. But please try it out. Let us know what you think, and we'd love to see what you create with it. Next up is a feature we're calling Smart Replays. And once you hear about it, you'll be wondering why you ever used dumb replays before. Basically, a replay is a bit of animation that you package together and turn into a triggerable event. So that includes draggers, head movements, lip sync, whatever you want. So for this frog character, for example, when I press the X key, he gets down, crouches, and jumps out of the frame like that. Now, if I record that in the current version of Character Animator, here's how it works. I press record, wait for the countdown, and I press X. The character does his jump. He's off and he's done. And this is what I'm left with. All of this stuff was just under that one replay. This is completely indecipherable. Like if I tried to edit this and edit the timing and what was happening here, I would have to go through so many different tracks to understand. Now you can see how complicated this animation is. There's actually a lot, you know, that went into this that made this work and look really great. But the problem is if I'm trying to mix this with other things in the animation, my timeline just gets so vertical and so confusing and filled with all this stuff I don't need. If only there were a better way to do things. Well, luckily there is. So when you click on your scene, by default now, this thing called Smart Replays should be enabled. So now let's try to go through the recording process again with Smart Replays enabled and see what happens. So I'm pressing record and I'm gonna hit X to do the jump. And again to stop, and let's stop recording. Okay, well that is a lot cleaner. Now I just have one thing showing up here that shows when my recording began and when that trigger, that replay begins and ends as well. Now, of course, I have full adjustability here. I can move this so if I want this to happen a little bit earlier, I feel like my jump needs to start here instead, I can do that. If I want to extend it out, I can do that as well. So I have all the options I would have normally for a trigger, showing up down here in one concise track. I think this makes replays just a lot easier for people to grasp and play around with. In the past, I think people shied away from the concept of replays because they can be very difficult to create and manipulate. But now with smart replays, I think it's gonna be a lot easier to add these little bite-sized animation triggers into your characters and really add a lot of extra life into them. So, again, I don't know why you would use dumb replays now that smart replays are out. So always keep that box checked from here on out, unless you really want to dig into the editing and get things, you know, your timeline looking terrible. But this is going to work a lot better. Next up, let's take a look at Puppet Maker. And the very first thing you can see is that we've added a ton of new styles here. So originally, we just had these three styles, Watts, Friday, and Proteus. But now we have a ton more. Here's Mo. This is a great character that has a lot of different options you can do. I'm just clicking the randomize button right now to move around with some of the variety that this character has. And it can get kind of crazy, but you have a wide variety of hairstyles, colors, all sorts of different things for a nice flat shaded style character. It's just a really, really nice one. Next up, we have the Professional, and this is a 3D modeled character that has a variety of outfits and uniforms that you can wear to make the character look like whatever you want. So a bunch of different character types here with suits and astronaut, all sorts of different things that you can play around with, and a lot of different color treatments as well to give a lot of personalized touches and variety. So you can imagine making a whole really nice cast of characters here with all sorts of different occupations, and it works really well for that. Next up is Chibi. This is a cute little character that has a ton of different mouth options, eye options, all sorts of different things you can put together to make for some really interesting characters. So really, really nice variety here. Lots of fun characters to play around with. I love this next one, Mega Robot. This is kind of a Frankenstein put together your own character. So you could choose everything from the same category to create like a Mexican wrestler type or an alien or something like that. But even more fun is to just randomize or click random parts and create all these wild and wacky creatures that are mixing, you know, all these different parts together. I just love the hand-drawn style here and all the fun, crazy options you can create. It really is just a lot of fun to play around with and see what you come up with. Next up is Noodles. And this character is this weird monster creature that has all these different variety of eyes and head shapes and colors and eyebrows and eyes. I think there's even like a three-eyed version here that if I keep cooking, there we go, randomize, I'll get to. So just a lot of fun. You can imagine creating a whole TV show with just a bunch of characters, you know, created out of this. So really fun to get a whole cast going. Next up is Blobby. And I just love this goofy character. It's just so much fun to play around with all the different setups that you can get from different neckwear, backgrounds, eyes, colors, all sorts of different fun things. And you'll notice that you get a ton of options over the background as well. So notice I can say, you know, if I want a door here, or if I need a couch to appear in the background, or maybe a plant, or the floor, you know, tiling, or anything like that. There's a lot of options to really customize not just the character, but the environment that they're in as well. And this leads to some really, really cool possibilities here. And then finally, we've got Hunter. This character reminds me of, you know, straight out of a comic book or something like that. We've got, you know, capes, top hats, all sorts of different treatments here. And it leads to a really interesting assortment of characters and clothing and prop possibilities. So if you want to make an animated comic book or something like that, this character might be your best bet there. Another thing you might notice is the speed overall has been much improved. So particularly as you're going through the customization options for a character, it's going to go a lot faster. If in the previous version you tried, you know, different colors of something, you may have noticed how slow that seemed to kind of go because we had to create all these layers and colors on the fly. Well, now we've kind of pre-cached all that stuff. And because of that, this works a lot faster. So you can just get in there and customize and have fun with it. And then the final thing I wanted to point out was up here, this name category. This came directly from your feedback. You all were saying, you know, we don't always want the default names for our characters. Is there a way to name them whatever we want? So you can call this, you know, monster, whatever you want. Let's call him Steve. and that looks good. And then when I generate my puppet, that is the name that's going to appear in the project panel and my scene and all of that. So I can really customize this to whatever I want. So that's it. We are really excited about how far this is coming along, and we can't wait to see what characters you create with it. So please try it out. Let us know how it goes. And as always, there is the dedicated page for this, the CH Puppet Maker page, where you can find out more information about walking through all the aspects of this and information on signing up if you are interested in creating your own characters like this. And then finally, body tracking is working better than ever. Hopefully you should notice less jitter, better performance, higher frame rates, all of that stuff, better tracking working overall. Thanks to all of your feedback and videos and characters and things you've sent us. Hopefully this is working better than ever. One thing to note is in the tracked handle section is we've added the head as a possible thing to track. This is just gonna make the head tracking more accurate as opposed to relying just on the face behavior to do the head tracking. Now the head is considered part of the whole system, and this is just gonna make everything work together a little bit better as you're playing around with stuff. Next, most of the full body characters on the homepage are going to allow for body tracking. So that includes Chloe, Hopscotch the Frog, Sam, Stardust, this new character Al, Tall the Cat, Bongo the Gorilla, Footy the Soccer Ball, Ninja, Thorn, and Heather. All of these will be trackable with body tracking, so you don't just have to go to the Body Tracker website to download the files anymore. They are all here and available to start working right away. Now, another thing that has been requested a lot is, hey, can I turn my body and have that actually affect my character too? And in the past, this wasn't possible, but now you can do it. So as I turn my body, you'll see the character changes into a quarter view over here. And then let's go back to the middle and then change to the side this way. And the camera is recognizing where I'm turning. And so you'll notice that the head turner behavior has now been changed and called the head and body turner. And so you can apply that to the body. And if you've set it up correctly, and you can use Stardust the Unicorn on the homepage to see how it's done behind the scenes, you can have a character that turns as well. Now notice this character is just turning the, from the torso up, and the feet are kind of staying planted in the ground. This just typically is gonna look better. Your character doesn't usually like shift their feet all the way to the side when they're talking to people, and that looks a little clunky. This looks a little bit better, but it's totally up to you. If you wanna do it that way, you can. So play around with this and see what you think about it. Another thing that helps a lot with body tracking now is after you record something, everything that has a check mark over here in your body behavior is going to show up as its own individual track in the timeline. So for example, here I made a mistake with my right wrist. I thought it, you know, needed to be in a better position. And so I recorded a second take of that wrist being slightly different. And that way I could just isolate only one element to fix instead of having to do a whole performance all over again. So if I wanted to fix something, all I have to do is uncheck, you know, the things that I don't want to track. And let's say I wanted just the left wrist, for example. So let's uncheck everything except the left wrist. Then I can do just a tracking of that wrist, record it, blend in that fix, and make it look like I got everything right the first time. So this just makes body tracking recording much more versatile. You don't have to worry if you make a mistake or something glitches out or something like that. You can always go back and fix it later.
So there have been a ton of improvements to body tracking. We would love to hear how it's working for you. So please try it out, dance around with some of these characters, and let us know how it's working for you.
And that's it. So a lot of really cool additions being added to the beta. We would love to get your feedback. And the best way to do that is not to go to the usual CH feedback forums page, but each of these features has its own individual beta forum post. And that's where everyone is giving their feedback. And we would love for you to add your own there. So for transcript-based lip sync, for smart replays, for Puppet Maker, and for body tracking, please check out the video description below for the appropriate forum post to post your feedback to, and that would be great. The whole team sees that, and that's what we can use to make all of these features even better for the future. So that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching, and have fun.